So the digestive enzymes, the hydrochloric acid, with age, people could go lower. After age of 45, people stop producing, slow down in their production of hydrochloric acid. At the age of 65, I think 80% of people are not producing hydrochloric acid. Well, what do you need hydrochloric acid for? Well, yeah, B12, folic acid, mineral absorption, iron absorption, calcium absorption, magnesium absorption. You need hydrochloric acid. Okay? That's one advantage. Second thing is we need CH3 groups. Okay? And you get that with hydrochloric acid. Methyl groups. And the methyl groups are needed to repair the DNA in enzymes. Every cell has 90 million methyl groups. Every cell. When we eat food, we lose about 18 million methyl groups per meal. If you do live food, you lose about 12 million methyl groups per meal. And there we go. So live food will cut it down by a third, but what we do with, we have the 18 hydrochloride, or the one we sell has all the natural methyl groups in beet, and it's a vegan, it's hard to get a vegan hydrochloric acid, you're replacing the methyl groups and therefore regenerating your system. That's the key concept here. So these are the two concepts. One, so you can absorb your protein, your B12, and you know, your folic acid and your minerals. And two, the use of methyl groups to, you know, that will rebuild and repair your DNA. Now, the other thing is same thing. The digestive enzymes that we have, and there are many good ones out there. I use Butyzyme a lot. The HCL is also very good. It's the father of enzyme research. And you take the hydrochloric acid and the digestive enzymes after a meal. The optimum time is an hour after a meal, but most people will never take it then. So if you are good enough to just remember to take it after your meal, you're good.
Every meal?
Yes.
The
bigger the meal, the more enzymes you take. But the bottom line of what I'm saying is, with age, we lose digestive power. And you don't want to do that because you want to be able to assimilate your nutrients. Yeah?
What about taking food acids like vinegar and lemon juice?
Apple cider vinegar can indeed stimulate hydrochloric acid. The trouble is it makes your body acid. That's the downside of that. If I get too alkaline, I'll take a tablespoon of apple cider vinegar and I'll bring my alkalinity back into order. So, but I don't recommend doing that because of the acidity problem.
I mean, talk about the quantity you put in your salad, not the quantity.
I'm talking about a teaspoon to a tablespoon. And I'm telling you, it makes you acid. That's what I'm saying. Literally, when I'm fasting and I'll go to a pH of 8 in my urine and I'll take one tablespoon, that's it, resets the whole thing and I'll get back to 6.4. 6.4 to 6.8 immediately. And it will stay there. You know. So what I am saying is those things are okay. They have a role, but I don't recommend it so much because most people are too acidic to begin with, and it does make you acidic.
The same with lemon juice.
Not so clear. Hydrochloric apple cider vinegar is much more acidic. It is acidic acid. pH of 2, I mean, it's strong. Lemon juice, sometimes it's going to make you alkaline, sometimes it'll make it acid. It's really not the same level. But the hydrochloric acid you need to do these jobs. The apple cider vinegar has been known to stimulate hydrochloric acid. Magnesium chloride is another trick to build your hydrochloric acid, as is salt. Good salt will bring chloride in for the HCL. Those are all things that help. But again, at a certain age, your pushing the limit, and you're better off taking hydrochloric acid to get your kind of reliable results.
What age?
45. 45 and up.
But if you eat salad, which is alkaline, and you put only half tablespoon or half teaspoon, so does it make such a big effect?
Well, in me it does. I'll tell you that. It's very powerful. It's much more than Paul Bragg kind of talks about. That's all I can say. You can check yourself. Check your urine before and after and see if it makes an effect.
So wait a minute, so if you're saying basically, personally, everyone, if you check in his urine and found that it didn't make that much of a difference, then for him personally it would be okay to take it?
Right. Right. But again, it's up to you. Getting acid, I mean, apple cider vinegar doesn't mean you're going to make hydrochloric acid. We're just saying it helps stimulate it. And ultimately, you want to, how are you going to know if you get gas and bloating because you're not making it? You take hydrochloric acid and you're able to digest and you don't get gas and bloating. That's how you know if it's working. So otherwise, it's just a theoretical discussion. Okay? Last thing before we end, because we do need to end, it's almost 4 o'clock, is, again, the other regular enzymes. I like Beautyzymes. It is a mix of protease, amylase, and lots of lipase, which is good for fatty, for fat digestion. Generally, the same principle. Your digestive power goes down with age.